wedding series that I started last week on my channel. Today's video is not going to be a bridal look. What I have done today is I've cooked up 5 important skincare tips that will help all brides, or if even if there's a wedding in your family, obviously everyone wants to look flawless. So these are 5 skincare tips that are kind of something that you should start incorporating right about now, which is about 2 or 3 months before your big day. So I hope these help you, because these are tips that I have incorporated during my wedding. And for those of you who don't know, I got married this past year in February. So I have incorporated a lot of these tips into my skincare routine before I got married. And I started about 3 or 4 months before I got married. And these really, really helped me. Because as a makeup artist, I know where a little help from your end in terms of taking care of your skin would help on the big day before all the makeup is applied. Obviously, the makeup on the big day is going to help you look absolutely beautiful and stunning and gorgeous, but these tips will help that makeup last throughout your function time. And also, you know, we have 4 or 5 functions happening and this all back to back, or maybe one day apart, and it's difficult to keep your skin in check at that point, which is why all of these tips will help you really keep your skin in check from now, so that it's not a sudden stress that you'll be giving your skin. So we're going to start with point number 5. It's going to be a countdown to the point number 1, which I feel is the most important point that you should be taking care of. And at the end, I'm going to give you another bonus tip that has nothing to do with skincare, but also adds big time to your final look for your wedding. So starting with point number 5, facials and pinups. Now we know that it's about 3 or 4 months left for your big day, and we know a lot of the salons are offering bridal services, bridal packages that are a mix of, you know, facials and cleanups that you do once a month or maybe twice a month and lead up to your big day. Now, it is important for you to decide whether you really need a facial or a cleanup so many times before your big day. For you to know that, you need to know what type of skin you really have. For example, my skin is combination skin and I have a little bit sensitive skin, so I tend to break out very soon. So after a lot of research and obviously a lot of experimenting on myself also, I realized that facials and cleanups don't help me give that glow or you know, that clear skin or things like that that really they claim to do. Especially if you go to a salon, they have their set of products. I'm not saying they are bad, but you need to know that if they're really necessary for your skin. For example, for my wedding, I went for just one facial, which was 2 days before my wedding, and that was it. I have noticed that every time I get facials and cleanups done, I tend to break out sometimes. My skin doesn't look glowy at all. That's because I realized when I read that if you have oily skin and if you are prone to breakouts, you cannot possibly have your skin scrubbed. If you scrub your skin while you already have breakouts on your skin, that the scrub, you know the amount of time you scrub your skin, it's a good 10 minutes. So that scrub is going to end up breaking all your pimples or even cutting the skin on top of your pimples and spreading them all over your face, which is going to lead to more infection around your face, which is going to lead to more breakouts, which is what you don't want. Another thing before we move on to point number 4 are masks. Now, masking, doing DIY masks at home are really good. Even little tips and tricks, you know, we call it grandmother's tips and tricks, are little things that you can do at home every morning to help make your skin look beautiful and get that natural looking healthy skin. Now, I do have a couple of recipes for DIY homemade masks which I have used and learned that they really do help. So if you guys want me to do a separate video on that, then please do comment in the comment section below. I will definitely do a video on that. But just a couple of things to mention here, little things. If you have dry skin, then taking malai, you know, we have milk boiling in our houses every morning and that forms a lot of natural malai. So if you have malai at home, just take a little malai on your hands and just rub it through your face before, I think 10 minutes before you go for your shower, because that is the best natural moisturizer you can get. Wouldn't recommend it much for oily skin people, but for dry, normal dry skin, it is a great moisturizer. Another thing, a natural toner that is really, really good for your skin is a slice of tomato. So you basically literally don't even need to puree it or anything. Literally just take a slice of tomato on your hand and just rub it on your entire skin. It's really good for open pores as well because it's a natural toner to your skin. Moving on to point number 4, we're going to talk about acne. So now, if you already have acne on your skin and your body that they're not going away, more and more pimples are forming, then I suggest that use a little bit of tea tree oil, maybe diluted in water, because tea tree oil is very, very harsh on the skin. It's very drying basically. But tea tree oil really helps get rid of that acne. I think Body Shop has a really good tea tree oil, which is what I use. So what you can do is just take a little bit of the tea tree oil on a cotton bud, and maybe you can dilute that with some water. So you can take it out in a little cup and just add a little bit of water to it, and literally before you sleep at night, just dip a earbud into the mixture and just spot treat your pimples. It is the best thing to do. Do not under any circumstances pop your zits. As much as you are tempted to do that, do not do it. It's going to leave a really bad mark on your skin. I used to be the queen of popping pimples, and my sister still thinks that I do it, but I don't. Moving on to the third point is treating your skin internally. Now, I'm not recommending any medicines over here, but what I'm talking about is something that you've probably heard 1,000 times, but believe me, it really works. If number one is water. So I know the last day, I remember this time I was practically attending exhibitions every second day. And when I mean attending exhibitions, I don't mean that I was going to an exhibition, looking around for an hour and a half, and coming back out. I remember days when my mom and me would go to an exhibition, for example, in Dome. And we would walk in at about 11:30 or 12, thinking, oh, there will be less crowd at that time. And it was so bad, we would end up walking out at 6:30, 7 in the evening. That's how long we would spend at exhibitions. And as a bride, you know it's not just your bridal outfits that you have to buy. There is so much that goes into your true show and all of that. So when you, to be brides, have to do that right now, I suggest that you carry a bottle of water with you wherever you go, but aim to have at least 2 liters a day. What that's going to do is really clear out all the toxins. You're going to pee a lot. I mean, I'm being really upfront, you are going to end up peeing a lot, but that pee is a good thing. It is flushing out all of those toxins that are in you, that are inside you. And the minute that starts happening, the minute that cycle starts happening, it's going to show automatically on your skin. Another thing under internal nourishment is a green juice. This is something my mother forced down my throat every single morning for the last 1 year. And believe me, I have loved it so much. I am married now and I still continue to have it every single day. A green juice is literally throw in any green veggies that you have and drink a glass of it every single morning. Believe me, it works wonders. I am someone who till date cannot even have a bite of tomato on its own because I puke because it's salad. I cannot have any salad. So what my mom did is she would really concentrate this green juice, about say 3/4 of a glass of it, and then add water to the remaining bit of it so that I don't feel the taste as much. And till date I thank my mom for it, because believe me, it's made such a huge difference to my skin. I know what my skin used to be like, I know how much it used to break out, and I know how discolored and dull it used to be. And these little things that I incorporated into my wedding, you know, pre-wedding diet has really helped me come a long way. I'm also going to put this recipe in the description box below in case you missed it right here. Moving on to the next 2 points, the last 2 points, the most important 2 points, and this has something directly to do with the makeup that you're going to be applying on the day of. So moving on to point number 2 are your lips. Now, a lot of us, thanks to our environmental factors or even other factors, have extremely chapped lips. So it is difficult for any lipstick to last on our lips once we apply. Even if we apply lipstick and it looks fine for a while, it starts looking cracked and chapped and really ugly in pictures. This is something that you can prevent on the day of your functions if you start from now to hydrate your lips every day. And when I say hydrate your lips every day, I don't mean just in the morning put a lip balm on your lips and leave your house. That is something, yes, you should do, but at the same time, you need some extra care and nourishment for your lips as well. This is amazing advice that I read on somebody's Instagram post. Someone had commented about this and I did incorporate it. So you know the Vaseline petroleum jelly that you get? So you literally just take that, apply it to your lips at night before you sleep and go to sleep. The petroleum jelly is so hydrating, it's so moisturizing, you will wake up with baby soft lips. But that's not going to help if you do it just one night before your function. Your lips need to be constantly hydrated. And you know that it is the best thing ever for you if you apply liquid lipsticks and matte lipsticks on your lips for your functions, because those lipsticks are going to last longer. But those lipsticks are also going to dry out your lips the most. If you are someone who is going to be applying matte lipsticks and liquid lipsticks to your lips for your functions, then I strongly suggest that you start taking care of your lips from now, from today. Because it is imperative that your lips are soft and hydrated before you put those lipsticks on your lips. Otherwise, your dry lips are just going to soak that lipstick up and it's going to end up making your lips look very chapped and very ugly. Another thing is you can do a little DIY exfoliating scrub. You can just take some honey and some sugar and you can just mix those two together and just exfoliate your lips before you're going for a shower. Literally, it takes 5 minutes. Just scrub your lips with the honey and sugar. Honey is a natural moisturizer, so it's going to help hydrate your lips, and the sugar drops are going to help you exfoliate. So down to point number two, coming to the main, most important point, something that all of us struggle with are our dark circles. And the only way that our dark circles are going to be covered, let's face the truth, our dark circles are not going to disappear. No matter how many creams you use that say that, okay, they will lighten them, they will disappear, dark circles will not be there anymore. No. Let's face the truth, the only way to cover dark circles is with makeup. But there is a very, very important role that you play in helping makeup cover your dark circles. And that is to hydrate your under eye area very, very, very well starting from today. So this is a little bit of piece of logic that I went by when I realized that I have extremely, extremely dry under eye circles. So what happens is when this area is very dry and you apply something like a cream concealer or a liquid concealer to this area, the area is automatically going to absorb all of that cream or liquid that you're applying. Because it is dry, the minute it gets some moisture, it's going to straight away absorb it. Now, just applying moisturizer just before your function, just before your apply makeup, is not going to help. After a point, that moisturizer is going to get absorbed, and because it is so dry, the concealer is going to get absorbed right away, right after. So what you need to do is start to hydrate your under eye circles from now, so they are hydrated enough by the time your functions are starting, and the concealer will then stay on your skin as opposed to getting absorbed into your skin. So to do this, you can do a little test for yourself. You take any normal moisturizer that you have and just apply it on your under eye circles. Just literally take a little more than you would normally apply on your face and just dab it into your under eye circles and see how quickly that moisturizer is getting absorbed. If it disappears right away, there's proof right there that your under eye circles are extremely dry. Now to remedy that, always use hydrating eye creams. Now you don't need to use eye creams that are anti-aging or help with fine lines or help with dark circles. It's not necessary. What you need to do is just take a nice moisturizer, even your everyday moisturizer. If it is not lotion consistency, if it is a nice thick consistency, just take that and apply that to your dark circles twice a day. Trust me, for me as a makeup artist and someone who's been through the overly dry under eye circles, it will really, really help your makeup artist on the day of your function, and it will help you as well, because no matter how much concealer you pack on your skin, if your under eye area is dry, the concealer is going to be absorbed within 15 minutes and your under eye area is going to start to look grey and your dark circles are going to start to show through. That's not going to help with the flawless skin that we all want to have on our makeup. And we're done, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful. And of course, I've not forgotten my bonus tip. It has to do with hair. By talking a little bit very quickly about hair, is that if you plan to color your hair, it is something that I was recommended by my hairstylist. My hairstylist was Ritika. I don't know if you know her. She was my Ritika hairstylist on Instagram. She's a celebrity hairstylist and she's absolutely fantastic at her work. So I was not planning to color my hair before my functions at all. I wanted a very natural look. I didn't want any hair color because I know I had the impression that it looks really ugly with Indian clothes. It's just too much. But she told me that if you don't color your hair, your curls and whatever texture we put in your hair is not going to show. Because if you curl totally black hair as opposed to when you curl hair that has a little color in it is going to give a very different look, and it's going to look more beautiful. And thank God, I swear, there was a good 20 minutes when we were just chatting with each other, and she has coaxed me into coloring my hair before my wedding. And thank God I did it, because my pictures have turned out great, my hairstyles look amazing with the hair color. But there are a couple of things you need to keep in mind before you color your hair. Number one is, you don't want to go too light. If you go too light, try to go too light on the day for your wedding. Let's face it, unless you are ridiculously fair or pale, on our beige shaded skin tones, very light blonde does not look good. What looks good is a blend of light and dark. What I had done for my wedding, I'm just going to put a photo right here. You can see right here what I had done for my wedding. I had gone to Jean-Claude, and the lady over there, I told her all my concerns. I told her, look, I'm getting married. I don't want something very stark, and I don't want something too light. So what we went for was a mix of three colors. All the three colors were in my hair. They weren't mixed together. They were all three colors were in my hair. She had taken different strands of a dark brown, a medium brown, and then something very light. So the majority of the color in my hair was the dark and medium brown, and then I had a few strands of the light color in my hair, which really gave it a beautiful sort of a mix and a beautiful natural color to my hair. And third and the last thing for hair color is, get it done at least 15 days before your first function is about to start. You don't want to make a mistake of getting your hair color done a day or two before your function start, because if God forbid something went wrong and you want to fix it, then you have that time to have your hair fixed. Secondly, the day you get your hair color done, for the first week, it looks extremely stark. It looks very different. And you need at least 3 or 4 washes for the color to settle down into your natural hair. Which is why it is imperative you get your hair color done at least 15 days. I got it done a month before my wedding, but at least if you get it done 15 days before, that is a safe amount of time to correct any mistakes and to let the hair color naturally settle into your hair. So that's it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you guys have any questions about anything and would like to see any other videos specific to the Big Fat Indian Wedding, then please do comment in the section below, and I will see you in my next video.